Ladies and gentlemen, welcome again to Bank of Baroda Baitak. Please note to catch performances at the Jaipur Music Stage this evening by L. Subramaniam's Global Fusion and then later followed by Medieval Pundits. Please avail your show tickets online on Book My Show or at the venue Clark's Amer. Thank you. We will have the next session numbered 88C in your program sheets. The Changemakers, Bollywood behind the scenes. And for it, we have this clip.
United Film Organizers, the new standard for on-demand international quality films in digital high definition.
Transcends borders and boundaries. When its language breaks barriers,
cinema for me plays a very, very big role. It's a very beautiful and important stature. It allows you to ask very pertinent questions.
First time I worked on a movie, it was absolute madness. It was crazy. It was a roller coaster. It was a whirlpool of emotion.
Not everyone needs to be born into the profession. You can just stumble on it and still work on it at your own pace and with your own faith.
So I truly believe that if you love what you do and you're willing to work really, really hard, this is an industry where you'll find a place for yourself, and it doesn't matter where you've come from or who you know or anything like that.
Our country really needs to have inspirational stories, because we have people coming from various parts of India who really don't have a clue how to go ahead and achieve their dreams.
think the book has, how people from possibly nowhere or possibly somewhere got higher. So I feel anything that takes anybody a step higher is a good thing to be informed about.
होंगे नई स्टोरीज होंगी उनकी रियल लाइफ की सीखने मिलेगा.
They should read this book to get an idea of the changing attitudes towards life, you know, in general.
And I think I've never really shared my story personally, professionally, in this depth.
It's not just about Bollywood as an industry. It's just not about what happens behind the scenes. I think every chapter, to the extent that I know, is dedicated to a human story.
If, you know, young women and even men in small towns read a book like this and they suddenly get to know of career options which they would have never traditionally thought of, to me that would be the great victory of this book.
I also think the book will be an amazing showcase to tell people about the various opportunities and possibilities that exist in this media and movie making space.
I'm also a part of this book.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the panelists for this session. Gayatri Rangachari Shah, Geeta Tandon, Guneet Monga, Mallika Kapoor, Priya Seth, and the moderator for this session, Ravi Agarwal. This session is specially presented to you by UFO Movies.
Hi everyone. Gosh, before I say anything else, just look around you. This is an amazing gathering. I can't even count how many people are here, but it's like 500 people, and we're quite literally a bear tuck up here in the front where people are sitting.
And it's lunchtime.
So thank you for coming. I'm really excited about this session more than any other one this week, because we're here to talk about an amazing book called Changemakers. And you must read the book, you must buy the book. And the reason why I say it's amazing is that it takes on an issue that really is very important for us. For many years now, we've all known the names of Bollywood stars who are on screen, and male and female, obviously, but you know, the people who are behind the camera, who make the movie magic happen, those names are harder to get to know, but one thing we have known for many years, it's mostly men. But a lot of them now increasingly are women as well, and that really is an inspiring, wonderful thing that's going on. Changemakers tells the stories of the women who are making movie magic behind the scenes. So you may not know their names, and that's one thing we're trying to correct today in the book, but also with our panelists here. So I'll quickly introduce them. We have Mallika Kapoor and Gayatri Shah, who are the authors of Changemakers. And they've really written an amazing book. And we also have with us Priya Seth. We have with us Geeta Tandon and Guneet Monga. So a round of applause for them as well, please. I'm gonna start off, Mallika, with you. If you look at the Indian economy of the last 20 years, one of the amazing things is, and as a journalist, you've been telling the Rising India story. And the paradox with the Rising India story is that there are fewer women in the workplace than before. In 2005, about 35% of the workforce was female, but now that's dropped quite sharply. And yet, even as women are dropping out of the Indian workforce, one industry is bucking the trend, Bollywood. That more and more women are getting into Bollywood and working behind the scenes and creating movies. So tell us about that and how that led to you writing this book.
I mean, that's exactly one of the reasons Gayatri and I started thinking about this book, is because of those statistics, which we found quite alarming. You know, being women in India, there was such a dramatic fall in the number of working women in India. And in that time period that you talked about, between 2005 and now, when the number of women working plunged, it's actually a time the Indian economy really grew. And it's a time when the number of women, of working age women in India grew, but we had women dropping out of the workforce except for one industry, and that took us by surprise because it's an industry that's for decades, I mean historically, been a boys' club. And here we were seeing more women working in Bollywood, particularly behind the scenes. So we did what journalists do. We started digging around and asking questions and being inquisitive. And we found there was this new generation of amazing, really gutsy women who were leading the charge and bringing about change. And we decided to find out more about their stories. When we did, we were blown away by their stories. And if we were blown away by their stories, we felt we had to share them with a wider audience.
And we're going to come to those stories in a second. Because they really are, you know, each chapter of this book takes on one person's story, and we have three of these amazing women here whose stories we're going to get into. But before we do, Gayatri, I just want to bring you in as well as the co-author of this book. You know, it's one thing for women to break into the industry, which is hard enough as it is, but in the foreword to the book, Farah Khan, the choreographer and now director, said that women, they have to put in twice the effort for half the appreciation. And so getting in is not just the only battle, it's even once you're in, it's really hard. Tell us about that.
Yeah, and I think that, the three wonderful women we have on with us here would obviously have very personal stories to share on that account. But, one of the things that we found when we were doing our research and talking to a lot of directors and producers and things is they actually told us, that they prefer hiring women now because women are so much more dedicated, so much more committed, and that's not to say that the men aren't, but they just have that much more to prove. So they work that much harder. So a lot of, including people like Raja, who Priya works closely with, have said that they love having women ADs, assistant directors and things, because they just feel like they just cross all their, dot all their I's and cross all their T's. So I think what is really heartening from this process of writing this book is that I think it is now much more accessible to join the industry than, let's say, a quarter of a century ago or even 20 years ago. I think that we would all sort of agree with. Getting the jobs, having that network to be able to get the next gig, I think that is still a work in progress.
Yeah, that makes sense. Guneet, I want to come to you. Your, as a producer, your story is truly amazing. You bootstrapped your way to, making movies and then traveling all over the country to show your movie to people, get them to watch it, make money off of that. And then later, when you took your movies to America, you were, going from studio house to studio house and saying, please watch my film. Your journey is really inspiring and incredible, but I have to ask, was it made harder by, tell us about the role that gender played in this. So being a woman, did that make it much harder? If you were a man, how would this have been different for you?
Well, I only realize it now that maybe on a hindsight, maybe there were opportunities that I did not get because I was a woman. I was also a really young woman in my 20s trying to be like this producer. India particularly is also very ageist, besides being, just young people don't get equal grounds. I actually always faced I never let this thought also cross me, to be very honest, that, oh, I can't do this because I'm a woman. So I never even projected it or saw it, but I did miss out a lot of smoking breaks, deal closures, I did feel left out of
so
not...
So just elaborate a little bit. So you're saying then that at the workplace or on a set, the men step away to smoke and no one asks you to come join them or...
No, I mean, not that even I want to, but I actually...
Don't smoke.
No, I don't smoke. But what I do have in a lot of... Not even on set. This doesn't happen on set. But on a lot of deal closures, you know, when you're sitting with a bunch of lawyers and you're sitting with the studio, suddenly they take a break and they go for a smoke break. And that's where some sort of secret conversation happens and some sort of bonding suddenly has happened in 5 minutes and they're back with new understanding. And I've always had to catch up. And I was like, but, you know, because I was just waiting. So I think that's some places I have seen... and I've seen people walk through me and not acknowledge my presence and always be like, oh, anyways, I'm going to close the deal with the guy in the room. Like, just looking, not looking at me in the eye, you know. My business has been a lot of deal making, you know.
Yeah.
And yes, of course, on set, stuff like, madam, aap se baat nahi karni, you know. आप से negotiate नहीं करना, madam आप तो रह नहीं दो, you know, तो I was like, क्यों भाई, मैं ही पैसे दे रही हूँ, मैं ही आपका check sign कर रही हूँ, you know, तो आप you better well talk to me.
Yeah.
So there are like all those things, and you have to always constantly push the door and open it, कि you know, madam से negotiate नहीं करना, madam से क्या बात करेंगे, madam को समझ नहीं आएगा, अरे madam ये आपका काम नहीं है, अरे क्यों नहीं है भाई, तो you're all working for me. So वो मुझे उनको समझाना पड़ता था.
Right.
So, yeah, stuff like that.
Right. Now, obviously, so Gunit's a producer and has made amazing movies. You've probably seen The Lunchbox or Masaan, for example, and she's the woman behind them. So, you know, and...
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And she's just been... And she's just got an Oscar nomination as well for her latest movie. It's called Period.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you.
Do you want to quickly tell us about that movie?
Yes, actually, it's a film called Period, The End of Sentence. It's a short doc. 2 days ago, we got nominated in top five. And 24th Feb is the ceremony, so we will know. Please pray. Let's cross fingers. And it's a short doc that follows a mini revolution that happened when we installed a pad machine in a small village in UP called Hapur. So women found jobs, they became a self-sustaining unit where 9 women were employed on a pad machine to start making pads to better menstruation health of young girls in the town and in their immediate environment. And shuru mein jab wo pad machine lagi thi, it's a 25-minute doc and we follow them from making the from setting up the machine to making it running. Shuru mein when the machine was set up, men came to break it down, ki ye tum kya bana rahe ho? And the women had to tell their men, ki hum Huggies diaper banane ja rahe hain. You know, hum log pads nahi bana rahe. So they had to lie through, otherwise they would like break it, burn the unit. And then slowly, we closely worked with Action India and we followed the journey. This, what is very beautiful about this shot is that this was an idea of 12 to 14-year-old girls in Oakwood School in LA. And they read that there are girls in little villages who attach so much shame to menstruation that they don't go to schools and miss out schools. So they did bake sales and yoga-thons and collected $3,000 to donate one machine. And then that one machine was set up and then they were like, what are we doing about it? Let's make a short film. They hired a 24-year-old graduate from USC to come direct. And then they were all like, what do we do? How do we get to India? That's where I came into the picture and I was like, okay, I'll be your producer. Let's make this happen. So yeah, it's a very, very cute film and it's very empowering and I would love everybody to see it. I hope we'll release it very, very soon, but please watch out for it. It's called Period, End of Sentence and it's up for the Oscars.
And come Oscar night, please remember her and keep your fingers crossed.
Yeah, I'll be running around. I actually thought that we'll be distributing pads to everyone. The unit actually makes
that's
pads.
That's a great idea.
The unit actually makes pads and they're called Fly and they're biodegradable pads. So we want to promote Fly, so making those women more self-sustainable.
Yeah. Wonderful. Thank you. Priya, I want to bring you in. You know, this book is obviously full of stories of women who are behind the scenes, and you are literally behind the camera. And, you know, most people think of a camera person and they instinctively just say cameraman. Except you're a camera woman and you're a director of photography and you have an amazing eye and you've created all of these beautiful scenes and shots and films, many of which I think people here would have seen. But tell us about sort of the casual sexism that you have clearly encountered and how it's changed you as a person and how you've dealt with that.
I think what happens is, as you said, there is no word other than cameraman for the job that was done. So we came up with, you know, this camera person. And as people in my crew started calling me, camera ma'am. Because
camera ma'am. That's great.
So I think when I started out, it's again, like Guneet said, you know, it's something that you have no idea of. And you realize that in hindsight. When you actually stop to take a breath, I think after 20 years of trying so hard, you suddenly realize like, oh my God, that's what sexism is.
Yeah.
But you just completely block it out of your head because I think the insecurity of being a creative person to begin with, you're constantly questioning your craft and your talent. So you think and you put everything down to that and not the fact that you're not even part of all the big conversations because of your gender. Because you haven't grown up like that.
Yeah.
And I think you, because you haven't grown up like that, I think we can, you know, we walk into these careers because we feel we're equal. And in hindsight, with a little bit of maturity is when I turned around and said, I was never part of that game. I never got to sit in that room. The room which was open for me was a very different room. So whenever I was approached for projects, and it was like, but people were shooting with you. But 99% of the projects were not even available because how would I handle the pressure? These were things that were said to me directly. Will you be able to handle the pressure of a big movie? How will you lead a crew full of men? How will you last 100 days on a shoot lifting equipment? So it wasn't casual sexism, it was right there up front.
Yeah, yeah, rampant sexism.
Absolutely.
And yeah. I mean, in the book, it's also described, I mean, you changed the way you dress, you changed all kinds of things just to...
I think, you know, we were a bunch of us female cinematographers sitting and chatting about a couple of years ago, and we realized that you all start dressing androgynously and taking away your gender.
Yeah.
Because you just want to fit in so badly into that male room. And everyone was doing it. It wasn't just me. You walked onto set and you wanted to make sure there was nothing that would, you know, set you apart from any other man in that room. So definitely you started dressing differently and behaving differently.
I have to ask you a question. I was going to come to Me Too later, but, you know, in the last few months, the last few years, you know, our vocabulary of how to think of these things is changing. And I just have to ask you, I mean, if you had to tell men to do something differently in terms of how they speak to you in the workplace or how they treat you, what would you tell them? Like, what are the things you think clearly need to change instantly or easy fixes?
Well, mansplaining.
Yeah.
I think, you know, it's not so much now. I think when you come into senior positions of leadership, you don't really experience the Me Too or any, you know, people are generally a lot more guarded. But I think what happens is lower down the rung, what the girls actually go through in crews at junior levels from senior, it's the same thing, right? So what you would tell men to do differently is do not use your power with people who can't stand up to it.
That's a great point. Geeta, I want to bring you in as well. I mean, these are all so accomplished women you know, your story is incredible because you are one of a handful of stunt women in an industry that is, you know, dominated by men. But stunt men is you know, it's all men. I mean, that's just, it's, you know, there's so few women who do what you do. Tell us a little bit about what that's like and the problems you've encountered as a woman in that field.
प्रॉब्लम्स होती हैं स्टंट्स करने के टाइम समझाते हैं हमें जब हम स्टंट्स करने जाते हैं कि बहुत सी चीज़ें समझाते हैं कि ऐसा करो वैसा करो बट ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा स्टार्टिंग में ही बोल देते हैं कि लड़की से तो होगा नहीं एक लड़के को ऑलरेडी रेडी रखते हैं कि इससे नहीं होगा तो हम फटाफट लड़के से करवा सकते हैं मतलब मुझे तो एक बात समझ नहीं आती लड़के लोग हमको समझा दिल से समझाते हैं कि करना है या करने के बाद मजाक उड़ाने के लिए समझाते हैं ये थोड़ा कन्फ्यूज़न है मेरे लिए क्योंकि हमेशा बोलते अरे हो जाएगा तुझसे, हो जाएगा हो जाएगा, बट थोड़ी सी मिस्टेक होगी तो उसका फिर डबल बोलते ना खराब हो जाता है काम. तो स्ट्रगल तो बहुत है, अपने आप को प्रूव करने के लिए मुझे 110% कोशिश ही करनी पड़ती है जो मैं अभी तक कर ही रही हूँ.
Yeah, let's have a round of applause. There's no doubt that, you know, all of you have had to go through so much to get to where you've gotten to, and I can't even begin to imagine what that's like. But on the other hand, attitudes are beginning to change. Tell us about that, Gayatri. I mean, so why are attitudes beginning to change in Bollywood? Because in the book, you describe, if you take the broader span of the book, how things are beginning to look up, more women are entering Bollywood. What's going on there?
So
what are the
reasons?
I think
it's what Gauri said right in the beginning of that clip. You know, it normalizes it when there are more women present. And I think, you know, all of these women have proven themselves, and I think that becomes, you know, it's like leading by example. And so once you know that a woman can be the DOP, a director of photography, on a big budget action film like Airlift, well, okay, you know, that means that next time I don't have to think about the gender of the cinematographer, I can just go ahead and think about the skill set and take that bit out of the equation. So I think the more women there are present, and as I said, I think more women, the industry has become much more professionalized. It was only recognized as an industry by the government of India, I think, in 1998. So after that, there was access to financing, so that the unseemly side of the movie business has really started to recede. It's become a business. There are studios, foreign studios as well as Indian ones. Obviously, we have like all the streaming companies, you know, the digital companies that have come into India. So content is really, you know, there's this kind of race for really good content. And that actually, you know, the story, that doesn't really revolve around gender. It's whoever can provide the best content, and of course whoever can provide the best skills. I think that's what's happened, and I think because of that more women are now attracted to the industry as well.
And is Western money part of the thing here, Mallika? I mean, does that kind of funding change the previous model of funding?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think there's definitely, as Gayatri mentioned, the industry is seen to be a more professional place now, and you can't underestimate the role the studios have played. So many more international studios have set up shop in Mumbai, and it's taken away, you know, that sort of dirty association with funding. There was a time when Bollywood was, you know, the association with funding was that it was funded by the underworld. That is much less now, right?
I mean, it's cleaner. It's gone.
Have you had experiences like that where you've sort of seen dubious sources of funding in years past, and you know, no.
Sorry. You know. Sources of funding. No, I mean there is all this.
Hello. Okay. So I mean, India, the way the business is structured, the way the financing of movies is structured, it's 100% equity. So the money is coming from a studio or a private source. I mean, we don't have any tax rebates yet. We don't have any location rebates. I mean, UP just set up some percentage of tax rebate a couple of years ago. But largely, there's no government support, which is very unique to India. It's like, cinema is not seen as art and culture, and not that even art and culture is supported by the taxpayers' money, not in India. So the money is coming from a private source.
Yeah.
Now, that private source is usually studios, and it's far more structured, and everything is structured. Sometimes it is also from private equity, from private people, and those people are either massive builders or massive investors or funds. And if that's happening somewhere and someone's money is being filtered and somebody else is a front, we would not know. But it's, I would say, 95-98% it's all white and it's all clean and it's all checked. And that's how distribution happens. And with PVRs of the world, every ticket is counted. At single screen level, there used to be that time when there used to be a lot of non-reporting of tickets, but now even the tickets are that day reported, taxes are paid. So it's a very, it's clean, it's really, really cleaned up from what it was
That's
in 2000.
Yeah. We're going to bring in some audience questions, so have a think about what you'd like to ask. I'm just going to get one more thing in before I come to you. And I want to talk about Me Too. It's been wonderful to see this movement take off in India. It happened obviously after it took off in the West, and it began in the West through Hollywood, really, and big studio names being outed. Priya, maybe you can give us a sense of the initial reaction to that, and then when it came here, what was it like? What was that moment like, and have things changed since then?
Well, I think the initial reaction in India was a lot of nerves in the film industry.
Yeah.
Because there was one lot of people who were saying that, oh, but Bollywood's not like that. Everyone's family here, and no one does anything that's slightly untoward. Just trying to make sure that everything remained under the carpet. But even now, if you realize all the stories that have come out in Bollywood are all the mid-level stories. So all the real stories still aren't out, and they won't, because there is a code of conduct, and there is a closed club which sits at the top, and we don't hear a thing about it. So at mid-level and below, we've seen a lot of change. I think people will think two or three times before doing anything. But where the real power matters, I think it's still very closed.
So a lot needs to be done still. Let's get some audience questions in. Yes, the gentleman over there. Do we have a mic roaming about so we can get it to the gentleman in blue here, please? If you can just tell us your name and then a quick question.
Hi, my name is Jugal. My question is to you about...
Yeah,
so my question is about, as you said, usually there are always camera men and not camera women. Similarly, the same goes for in the space of stunts. But what I've seen, I used to work with Discovery a short while ago, and I realized that even for basics, if a bike needs to be elevated and goes through a glass pane and has to land, okay, basic things like, what sort of speed needs to be put on the vehicle, what sort of elevation is it, and things of those sorts, those are also doubted with, women, stunt women. So things in that space are they moving forward, or are you still facing same things? Like, they speak to you on basic things, ki ye aag hai, aapko pata hai isme se kaise jana hai, and things of those sorts, or are they, more progressive now? Are they speaking about, are you safe enough? Do you feel this comfortable for yourself, or things of those sorts? Or is this also, with that, under the layers of chivalry that they, punch you and say, oh, you are a woman, we need to take care we need to take more care of your safety and things
so
of those.
So let's have, Geeta, would you like to try that?
Glass break.
होता है ऐसा बहुत बार कि ग्लास ब्रेक करना होता है तो हमें बहुत सी चीज़ें समझाई जाती हैं स्पीड समझाई जाती है कैसे तोड़ना है हाथ कहाँ रखना है क्योंकि ग्लास ब्रेक एक बार करते तो बहुत लग भी सकता है और एक बार क्या हुआ कार ड्राइविंग थी मगर कार चेजिंग मतलब ठोका ठाकी थी पूरी तो मैंने उनसे खुद मांगा कि सर एक चांस दे दो मुझे कि मैं कर लूँगी क्योंकि ऑलमोस्ट किसी लड़की ने आज तक कार चेजिंग की नहीं है तो मैंने उनसे बहुत रिक्वेस्ट करने के बाद उनने हाँ बोला फिर अगर उनने ऑन द स्पॉट एक लड़का भी रखा था कि इन केस अगर मुझसे कार चेजिंग नहीं हुई तो वो लड़का करेगा बट मैंने वो पूरा किया पूरी 100 यूनिट जब मैंने पूरी कार चेजिंग की तोड़ा फाड़ी की तो बहुत तालियां बजी फिर मुझे कहीं ऐसा लगा कि हाँ भाई मैं कर सकती हूँ तो चीज़ें तो समझाते ही हैं वो लोग कि ऐसे करो वैसा करो बट चांस कम मिलता है लड़कियों को बड़ी बड़ी चीज़ें करने का
Let's, Can we? We're...
हाँ 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 एक्चुअली औरतों के लिए ही है मेन कि समझाते हैं कि लग ना जाए लड़की है ऐसा है वैसा है इसलिए लेकिन नहीं अगर मैं फाइटर बनी हूँ तो सब चीज़ें मुझे आनी चाहिए लड़की हो या लड़का वो मेरे लिए मैटर नहीं करता है जैसे वो करेंगे मैं वैसे ही मैं करूँगी
Let's get another question. I'd love to get questions from women. I feel like only men are putting their hands up, but... Okay, right there. Sure. Yes, of course. I mean, so what she was, you know, she was basically saying that she was agreeing with the question and saying that it was very hard for her as a woman stunt woman to, you know, to be treated and to be patronized. And so she sort of fought that patronizing attitude with an attitude of, you know, I can do it. Give me a chance, I can do it. That's what she was saying. And really, it's incredibly inspiring that as a stunt woman, she, you know, took on that challenge and proved herself time and time again in a very tough way. So a question, please. Right there. Yes.
Hi. So we've been discussing sexism behind the scenes in Bollywood. I'd like to ask the two authors and journalists, do you face sexism in journalism, and to what extent?
So it's a really good question. Obviously, we have seen that it exists since, you know, the newsroom was the Me Too movement started, you know, came to India, and Bollywood sort of had a few stories come out. But then, of course, the news industry really is where we saw a lot of action. And of course, there was a minister who had to resign, etc. So, you know, I before I was a journalist, I worked in finance for a long time, and I worked on Wall Street, etc. I was an equity analyst. And now I write on topics like this, art and culture. And I always feel like I'm dismissed as a journalist because I'm not doing the political stories or the business stories. And you know, it's because these are the softer subjects, and so there's, you know, quote unquote, less important. But actually, I mean, I actually think art and culture is what makes society what it is. So I feel like, you know, that if I sort of meet a male editor or male journalist who's really focused on those big stories on national news and all that, oh yeah, okay, nice to meet you, that kind of thing. That happens all the time. But you know, I don't let it bother me. So, and Malika, I don't know if you have.
Yeah, I mean, I think this is fairly typical for any working woman, and especially a working mom. You know, it's tough to juggle it all, and it's just the reality that it's tough. A lot of women face it. I think what I've struggled with sometimes is when you have male colleagues, sometimes, you know, they just assume you're going to put in 75% because you're going to go home to your kids. You want to get back on time, or you don't want to spend an extra day on a trip. So that is that kind of sexism. Yes, it's annoying. Did I let it come in the way of my career? I hope not. But yes, I think it's something any working mom faces.
And as someone who's worked with Malika, I can tell you, she did not let it come in the way of her career. These are all absolute rock stars. We'll take one last question there. Yes, the lady there who's putting her hand up.
Hello, everyone. My question is that, do you think that in the, like, generally Bollywood is considered as a taboo for middle-class girls? Like, if a girl says that, okay, dad, I want to become an actor, then she said that, okay, no, it is not secured, okay, because of casting couch and all that, which is still prevalent. So do you think that in that case, Bollywood is developing or progressing, or it has become more secure for girls to enter, like, keeping aside the casting couch and all these things. So do you think it is progressing or not?
Priya?
Definitely. And I think the reason for that is because the more women you see and the more women working there, the safer it's going to get for everybody. And safety was a big issue. I remember when I started working about 20 years ago or 22 years ago, if you finished a shoot late at night, you wanted to get out of the set first. You didn't want to be the last one there because you didn't know. It was also the kind of people. So the more the women on set, and now there are many, many women, I think we still have a problem of not too many women in senior positions. But just the sheer number of women on set, I think, makes it a far safer place and far more progressive at the moment.
And I remember when I started, my family was like, ladki Bombay chalegi, haath se nikal gayi. You know? And for translation, I would say the girl's gone to Bombay and she's just now gone. Like, we've lost her to this space. So that is how obscure Bollywood is, of course, for middle class India to see. But I would say it also depends with the environment you choose to work in, and how you respond to every situation that is there. Largely, it's a very safe and a progressive space. I have not had incidents of any such, you know, casting couch or anything, but having said that, you hear it all the time. So I just think it is what it would be in any other industry. So especially blacklisting Bollywood for this is not true and not fair. It is pretty cool and pretty progressive and be a part of good stories. And it's one can go forward in Bollywood, yeah. Or the film industry. I hate the word Bollywood.
Now, I'm afraid we're running out of time, so we're going to have to wrap up. But what I do want to say, just to end with, is that it's humbling to hear these stories of these amazing women. And I want you to know that, you know, the next time you watch a Bollywood movie, think about them. Know that, you know, your stunt woman, your producer, your camera woman, they are amazing women who've had, you know, really difficult paths to get to where they've gotten to. And that should inspire another generation of more women entering Bollywood. So a quick round of applause, please, for Geeta Tandon, Guneet Monga, and Priya Seth. I want you to think of them when you think of Bollywood movies. And one last thing, please buy the